Mr. BassWood County, warning, there's a criminal on the run.
Hey everyone, it's WOWMAN, and today's video I did want to focus on a little analog horror series called BassWood County. That chances are you haven't heard of it because it's pretty obscure, but that doesn't mean that this series isn't incredibly well done. It features these creatures called humanoids and focuses on the extremely disturbing things that these creatures can do to you. The series goes into some pretty dark places, including exploring the chamber, which is where these creatures are being created. But yes, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, as well as liking the video and commenting bruh as usual, because all of these things for some reason do help me out a lot. Also, I just got back from Seattle. I know you can probably tell. Anyway, if any of you are from there, it was super awesome, dude, and I saw the needle and I didn't die, so that's super cool. Have an Instagram post about it if you want to check it out, if you're interested. But real quick, I did want to thank the sponsor of today's video, which is Magic Spoons. Magic Spoon is a cereal reinvented. It's the same great taste that you remember, but upgraded with grown-up ingredients, nothing artificial. The variety pack comes in four delicious flavors, fruity, frosted, peanut butter, and my favorite, cocoa. And the cereal fits a ton of lifestyles. It's high protein, keto friendly, gluten free, grain free, soy free, wheat free, and naturally flavored. Magic Spoon cereal has 0 grams of sugar, 13 to 14 grams of protein, 140 calories, and 4 to 5 grams of net carbs in each serving. And this is such a good cereal not only because it's super tasty, but it also helps me to manage my sugar intake, because when I tend to eat a lot of sugar, I start to break out a lot of my cheeks, so this helps a lot. And just having this in my cupboard is a huge help, because I can just grab a bowl and not have to worry about cooking anything. It's just super good. And Magic Spoon is so confident in their product that it's backed with a 100% happiness guarantee. So if you don't like it for any reason, they'll refund your money, no questions asked. So start off the new year right by clicking the link below or scan the QR code on screen and use the code WOWMAN for $5 off, or go to magicspoon.com/WOWMAN to save $5 off on your order today. Alright, so the first video that we are going to be taking a look at in this series is called The Chamber. And technically it was the fourth installment in the series, although this one establishes a lot of the lore. So I did think that it was best to put this video at the beginning, because it does make these first three videos a lot easier to understand once you've watched this fourth video. So in it, the tape begins and we're introduced to Mr. Calvin Basswood. It says he discovered an odd building in the woods in 1868. He discovered it in what now is named after him, BassWood County. In his diary, he said that it looked like something from the future, a building that no one knew existed. He entered the building and saw people. They looked like human beings, but something was strange about them. They showed no emotions or response. They had unnatural limbs and tree roots coming from their backs. They began to show hostile behavior. He escaped the place. He called it the chamber. And he stiffens after the transformation. And after this brief segment, it goes on to say that a group of researchers in 1996 ended up exploring the same place that Mr. Basswood explored almost 100 years ago now. The researchers from Philadelphia ended up going with the goal to investigate the missing people that have disappeared within a month in BassWood County. And they end up going to the BassWood Forest and recorded the journey. This is what they saw. Within the footage, we can see the building that Mr. Calvin Basswood described, and it's then when the researchers enter the chamber and encounter the creatures Mr. Basswood had written about. Once inside, they see someone with their hands raised in praise, it seems like, but the top of their head is completely missing, and their ribs are completely exposed as well. As they continue into the chamber, there is also this creature sitting behind a desk with a VCR next to him playing a distorted face. The tape in the TV is called Identity Test, which is the name of a following video that we'll look at a little bit later. Above it, it reads a sign that reads, "I will tell you what your mind cannot comprehend." Looking further around the chamber, there is a clock, as well as a table with human remains and a skull on top of it. They then uncover the corpse of a woman with breaks and holes in her body. Her eyes were missing and her mouth had no teeth in it. Her skin was melting like wax. Followed by another creature with roots coming from its back, it then says that the group got out of the chamber and went into the basswood forest. And once they're out there, it becomes clear that the group was followed. Only 2 out of the 7 members of the group survived. After we are shown the map of the chamber, with the left zone being where the man with the TV was, and just from looking at this screenshot, it kind of reminds me of the layout of a church, with the main entrance in the middle, then expanding to the sides where the pews are supposed to be, and then leading to the center where typically the father would give a lecture. But that's really just me spitballing as to what this chamber could have been. In a second drawing, we can see that the window says danger. This is where they come from. But then the tape takes a shift in tone as we're given this very strange lesson on human anatomy and what it means to be human.
What is a human? Hello, I'm Doctor. In this tape I will teach you about the human anatomy. The human is a chamber for them. I will show you how they will control your body.
We're then told where a human's consciousness resides and what a human skull looks like after a creature has used it. And then we are shown the core that the creature puts inside of you in order to control you.
And here is the core. They create it so they can control your body.
It then begins to say something incredibly off-putting because the tape says, "Let us in the middle of the video, as well as saying humans have roots, can extend their neck, and have uncanny facial features.
Here are the characteristics of a humanoid. Long limbs, long fingers, tall, roots coming out of its back, can extend their neck, uncanny facial features, no emotions."
To which we are then shown the transformation of a humanoid, with stage 1 being its true form, however it progressively looks more and more like a human as time passes. Alright, so this next installment in the series, which was actually the first installment uploaded onto the channel, it is called BassWood County Humanoid Alert. It begins by warning the residents of BassWood Counties of a threat to their safety.
This is a warning from BassWood County Police Department to the residents of BassWood County and neighboring counties.
There have been numerous alerts about a humanoid creature that invaded the county, and that there have been 11 murders thus far. And after this, it begins to detail the conditions in which the victims were found, which does include decapitation, missing limbs, and puncturing of the neck. Then it goes on to tell us some pretty baseline advice, such as closing your windows and locking all your doors, something that that I'm pretty sure the citizens of Basswood County are already doing. Characteristics of these creatures include tall, long limbs, long neck, long fingers, unnatural face, menacing eyes, and smiling. But then it says short brown hair, which I do feel like is an odd detail to include, because as we've seen before, these creatures do take your body, so do they only attack people with brown hair? We're then shown a height comparison from the humanoid and a regular human, and it shows that they are almost twice our size, reaching around 9 to 10 feet. Then it follows with a segment that tells us to identify the creature from 5 sketches, with each sketch getting progressively more disturbing.
To make you able to identify this creature, we are going to show you 5 police sketches that were drawn according to eyewitnesses' descriptions.
That is until we are shown a regular person, which means that the transformation is complete, as they look pretty much identical to a regular person. Found footage follows, dated January 22nd, 2022, which shows someone recording this underground area, which most likely leads to the chamber. Then it switches to footage that was recorded back in October 7th, 1998, of someone having an encounter with the humanoid, and it is extremely chilling to watch. So I am going to put a disclaimer now, please lower your volume if you don't want to get super jump scared right now. All that was left behind from this incident was a severed arm. This was found in the victim's basement, according to Detective Jeff Alberson. We're then shown this page, which looks like it was ripped out of an old book, which does look really similar to a Grimm's Fairy Tales page, so I did think that was kind of interesting. I actually have the book, so I'll show you real quick. But yeah, you can kind of see that it has like a very similar kind of aesthetic as the note that we're shown in the video. But the point I'm trying to make is that this page is extremely old. For example, the Grimm's Fairy Tales were published in 1812. So just based off of visual aesthetics, I'm guessing that this was created around the same time as well. However, within this ripped page, it's extremely hard to read what it says. However, from what I can gather, it says something along the lines of, "Beware from the creature, runner, runner. I will killer thee, has thy family. I will cutter thee to pieces. I looks there a blank." So if you guys can decipher this any better than I can, be sure to let me know in the comments. After this, we get some more camcorder footage dated on November 8th, 1998, a month after the previous recording, and we can see the humanoid replicating a human. The next video does follow Jeff Alberson, which is the police detective that found all of the tapes that were featured in the last video. His tape begins by stating, "During the investigation of one of the victims' houses, Detective Jeff Alberson found some tapes recorded by, redacted, the house owner. The police scanned the tapes and found the recording of a victim's rooms before the break-in by the anomaly. Under supervision of Detective Jeff Alberson, these tapes were named Jeff Alberson's Footage Collection Tapes, 1998, as they were collected by him. The police also found a sketchbook that does belong to the victim. These were the drawings inside of it. And in the drawings were shown the slow progression of the humanoid, revealing its true form." and in a tape labeled November 2nd, 1998, we yet again see another recording of a humanoid. The next one is called Identity Test. So for this one, it was the VHS that was playing when researchers went inside of the humanoid chamber. It starts off by giving us an identity test, which was created by Basswood County.
Time for you to change back and return to your provincial university. And if I...
But creepy enough that in this tape it says that it's prohibited by law to view this footage. So perhaps the county is hiding something that the citizens are completely unaware of. You're instructed to examine the following human faces to test your recognition of uncanniness in them. And it does start off simple enough. It shows you a bunch of standard human faces, which all appear to be normal. That is until this face appears, which marks the shift in tone, because we're shown a silhouette and are asked to determine what its face looks like. But then the next segment gets incredibly strange, as we're shown this person who appears to be under surveillance. And according to the timer that's under them, they've been under surveillance for 16 hours and 23 minutes. It's dated June 12th, 2002. And then in footage from January 12th, 1992, we are shown this. The next segment is called The Failure of Jeff Alberson, who after investigating these humanoids, he now faces one himself. A chamber in the woods, where they come from a door to a realm. We know where you live. And this following part is a little bit hard to follow, so I will play it in its entirety and then we'll regroup and discuss it. So this part is incredibly disturbing because it does seem like the humanoids are recording people before they decide if they are ready to be harvested, aka ready for them to take their bodies. Which is an extremely terrifying concept, having an entity spy on you without you even knowing, just completely plotting your demise. It's just very unsettling. Alright, so in this one, things take a little bit of a different approach, as there has been a certain humanoid in Basswood County who has begun to hunt humans.
There's a criminal urban, but witnesses who lived have said that he is not a normal human being.
Where before they would only take a person's body to use it, now they're doing it for sport. This video acting as a warning to all Basswood residents, which at this point, it's probably smart to just move very far away from this place. Through this radio broadcast, it states that there has been witnesses of this creature, saying he is not a normal human being. It travels at incredible speed. But what's even stranger is that sometimes he doesn't even kill his prey. He would just tie them up and leave them where he found them. Then we are shown some footage of the creature. And after this, we are shown what the creature did to one of the people it hunted. The last video in the series is called Before You Sleep, which I hope you aren't about to go to sleep right now because this is probably going to ruin it if I haven't already. This video was also released about 2 weeks ago at the time that I'm filming this, so I'm pretty sure there are going to be future installments to this series that are soon to come. But for now, this is the final video in the series. It starts off with someone who is experiencing being taken over by a humanoid and documents their descent into losing who they were as their consciousness is slowly being taken over by the humanoid inside of them. And this does remind me a lot of the show Scavenger's Reign, because in that show there's a character who slowly loses their sanity by a creature that is controlling them, essentially feeding them their deepest desires as a way to completely take over their body and make them do whatever they want. But yeah, if you haven't seen that show, I would highly recommend it. It's probably one of my favorite shows of last year. I feel like my soul is being dragged into that place, taking over my mind. I can't sleep anymore. I'm going insane.
Welcome to BassWood County's informational tapes. After many reports of lack of sleep, degrading mental health due to insomnia and night terrors, this tape will give you methods to have a healthy sleep and make a spiritual distance between you and the...
And based off of this broadcast, it really does feel like the county of Basswood have accepted the fact that there are people being controlled by the humanoids and are now just giving you methods on how to deal with your new parasite. But then a humanoid asks you if you are still awake. The methods for a better sleep are to go to sleep at 10 to 12 a.m. to 2 a.m. and avoid the odd hours as they may put you at risk of the wanderer effect, which makes you sleepwalk. The second tip is to look at the clock before sleeping and to see if it's ticking or if it has stopped ticking, something is wrong. Then it just skips to the fourth tip, which is completely wrong, because it tells you to sleep and to let them in. But yeah, that pretty much does it for the Basswood County analog horror tapes. Feel free to let me know your thoughts and theories as to what you think is really going on here. I'd love to read them. Also, huge thank you to my channel members, as well as my ultimate tiers, Dreditor, Kareem Arellano, Alejandra from the Tower, K-pop Lover X3, and 1998. If you want early access to videos, as well as your name right here, it's only $1.99. But yeah, thank you so much for spending some time with me. Your time is super valuable, so I appreciate you spending it with me. But yeah, I'll see you later. Bye. Love you.